welcome to this week's Monday Minutes. My name is Kelly.
And my name is Jessie, and happy KohaCon week. I just can't hold it in. Okay, this week we are going to talk to you about lists. Everything from viewing those lists in the OPAC to creating these beautiful curated lists for your users to the staff side where you can actually use lists for modifications of tools. And if you follow us regularly, a couple of weeks ago, we talked about how you can use patron lists in a dynamic way in order to modify things.
I just think that there's the possibilities of lists for lots of reasons, whether internally or obviously to assist your patrons in finding things externally. But there is great ways to use this functionality.
Absolutely. So for our users out there, if you have lists created and you're using them, you'll see a drop-down menu which shows you any of your public lists. And then again, I am logged in so I can see my private lists as well. So these public lists are a great way for you to highlight things in your collection. Staff picks, Oscar nominations 2022. Kelly, we needed to get an Emmy nominations in there 2022.
I know.
But this would show you just a great way to look at what's available and curate something really great for your users.
Yeah. And from a list for patrons, they could send it, download, add their own holds to it, and they can actually see in the results when something's linked to a result, linked to a list, and then find others.
Yep. So again, as Kelly mentions, you know, you can download, you can email it off. And then, of course, you can print it or make edits. So just a really great way to be able to come in here and view that information within the system. And again, just from a simple search, add some more cookbooks in there. This will allow us to come in and from the screen, probably one of my favorite things is being able to just say like, you know, selecting multiple ones and then coming in here and then adding those to the list. So quickly coming in and grabbing those in there.
Yeah, it's really fantastic. And then just to say, you know, sharing them with a study group or some sort of book club, you can certainly do that.
Okay, Kelly, jumping over to the staff interface. So let's talk about the staff side.
Yeah. So the same functionality that Jessie showed, searching the catalog and adding things to a list, is the possibility. You can certainly create a new list or add to existing on the staff side, doing the same thing, making those check marks. And then it's kind of in the same place, add to a list.
Perfect.
You have both the options of, on staff side, you have the options of a private or public list. So as staff, if it's public, it is going to be pushed out. If it's private, maybe it's more of an internal use.
So we'll come into the lists module within Koha on the staff interface. And this is going to show us both our lists, which are our private lists. And then again, our public lists, which is lists that will be sent out to the public interface. So Kelly, should we walk through creating a list in the system?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Okay, so now we're going to create a public list. Well, let's call this Kelly Fall.
All fun. It's all getting right. A little chilly here in Maine.
So we can either sort this by title, author, copyright, date, call number, or date added. It can be private or public. If it's private, it would just be for me as a user. If it's public, that means it will be visible on the OPAC. And then the last option you'll see here is to allow changes to content from, and you can set it to nobody, owner only, which would just be me, and then anyone seeing this list, which would allow others to make changes to that particular list.
Now, Jessie, two things I thought of while you were talking about that. You know, you could always have a list like this fall fun, make it public for a bit and then turn it to be private when it's no longer fall. So that's kind of a nice active, inactive option. Great. So you don't have to get rid of what's in your list.
Yeah.
Secondly, I've known libraries to have sort of a staff account for lists in general. So then that owner only would pertain to anyone logged in as the list owner. That's, you know, that person that's the list creator, because then you don't give it to everybody that can see it, but you give it to just enough staff that have access to that permission-based list maker account.
Great suggestions, Kelly.
Thanks.
Okay, so once we create this list, we can go in and add items. This would allow us to either scan the barcodes, or if we ran a report, we could add those biblio numbers right in there.
Thinking about all those records that don't have items, your electronic resources, you can easily go ahead and add those without having barcodes.
And let's say we do want to edit this list, we can come back and it will give us those same fields again. Yep. So why don't we come in here and we'll just do another search here, and we'll show you again how you can quickly add those in. So, you know, we see a couple on here that we may want.
Your fall fun is a little different than mine, but we'll go with it. We'll go with it.
Yeah.
I love it. I like big, longer books during fall. So,
mm-hmm. Okay. All right. So we'll save those in there. And now we have our fall fun list created.
Yeah. Yeah. And why don't we do one more thing, Jesse? We talked about how you can use lists for batch operations. So we could go ahead and do a quick batch operation using a list that we just created.
So now we'll come in and we'll do some of those modifications. Batch record modification would allow us to come in. This gives us options to either upload a file. So if we ran a report, Kelly, we could add mm-hmm. that in.
Yep.
Or we could come over here and select from a list. And here we go. So we can come in here, select our fall fun. If we needed to use a template where we wanted to do some record cleanup, we could select that, hit continue. It would show us those three titles that we've created on the list, and then we could come in and modify those records.
Yeah, it's perfect. Like if you wanted to suppress a whole bunch and you were adding them to a list, you know, anything, it's nice to have that project theme attached to lists.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. All right. Well, make sure to stream KoaCon if you are not there in person this week. Mm-hmm. If you are there in person, we can't wait to see you.
Can't wait to see you, and travel safe. And we'll see you Tuesday.
Bye.